The Philippine government will not impose martial law and a total lockdown. That clarification coming from acting presidential spokesperson Carlo Nograles. Following rumors, the government will use militaristic approach to help slow down the rapid increase in COVID-19 cases.
Habang nagpupulong ang gabinete, kumalat kahapon ang isang voice clip ng isang babae na nagsasabing magkakaroon ng total lockdown at martial law. Fake news po ito. Huwag po tayong magpapaniwala sa mga ganitong uri ng balita. Please get your news and information from credible sources only. Kaya naman po, binabalita agad natin ang mga bagong hakbang laban sa COVID para alam kaagad ito ng taong bayan.
Nograles also warns the public against spreading misinformation online.
Sa mga walang magawa na gumagawa at nagpapakalat ito, tigilan nyo na po ito please. Hindi ito biro. We are dealing with a real threat that understandably concerns our people, and spreading baseless and malicious rumors contributes to unnecessary anxiety and to needless panic. Hindi po ito nakakatulong. Umpisan po natin ang briefing.
Over a dozen more areas are placed under COVID-19 Alert Level 3. These include the cities of Baguio, Olongapo, Naga, and Iloilo, as well as the Cagayan Province, Pampanga, and Bataan. The stricter alert level will be imposed from January 9th to 15. Authorities earlier placed Metro Manila, Bulacan, Cavite, Laguna, and Rizal under Alert Level 3. Meanwhile, more provinces have also tightened health protocols for visitors. Travelers going to Boracay, Iloilo, and Naga are again required to present a recent negative RT-PCR test. The municipality of Bontoc has also banned travelers from areas under Alert Level 3 from entering the province. A former government advisor wants tougher mobility restrictions in Metro Manila amid the rapid rise in COVID cases. Dr. Tony Liachon says the capital region should be placed under Alert Level 4 for at least 2 weeks to prevent an even bigger outbreak.
Yung Alert Level 3 na nagawa na natin starting January 3, parang hindi nakatulong siya. Ang rule kasi sa hammer and dance concept, pagka ganito ka-steep ang curve at saka ang transmission mo taas, baka kailangan itaas mo sa alert level 4 ang epicenter. Ang problema ho natin, pag kumalat ng kumalat yan, baka buong Luzon madamay. Ang Visayas and Mindanao natin po ay problema because of the typhoon. At alam naman nyo, baka makarating sa Bicol, tapos makarating sa Bismin, tapos yung mga evacuation center in the countryside, madamay po ito. Mahihirap, gigiba po ang healthcare system natin.
The Philippine Health Department preparing for the worst-case pandemic scenario. Health Chief Francisco Duque III says they are ready to source health workers from different sectors. These includes the police and the military, as well as postgraduate interns. Duque adds his agency will deploy frontliners from the different parts of the country if hospitals in the capital region are overwhelmed again.
Postgraduate interns waiting for the results of their board exams. So they are being asked by the hospitals where they finished their internship to help, to volunteer. So meron na po tayong programang ganon na nakakatulong po sila on top of our regular human resource for health. And we also have an augmentation program. We are making sure that all available healthcare professionals will be on deck and prepare for the worst case scenario.
President Rodrigo Duterte meanwhile promised to raise the special risk allowance given to volunteer health workers.
I think that the 5,000 is masyadong maliit ngayon. considering the attendant danger to the guys, medyo they should be given more. You take into account the possibility of danger. They themselves will get the, because of the, they have to go near and they have to treat those people. I will increase, hindi ko pa masabi magkano, wala mang budget dito.
Tama po kayo, 5,000 is a pittance that will not really attract or properly incentivize these volunteers, no? Considering the risk that they will face. So a much higher amount is in order.
The delayed release of health workers' benefits triggered protests from medical frontliners across the country last year. For the Alliance of Health Workers, simply increasing their special risk allowance is not enough to properly compensate them. The group's president, Robert Mendoza, says government should double the salary of all healthcare workers to help solve understaffing problems in public hospitals.
Kung nadoble ni President Duterte ang sahod ng mga kapulisan, tublihin na sana para manatili yung ating mga health workers dito sa ating bansa at hindi na umalis. Hindi po sapat yung 5,000 nito, kaya kailangan talaga kasi ang panawagan niya namin dito sa special risk allowance doon sa Senado habang dinidinig ang ating budget ay dapat maging 15,000 po ito. Dapat itaas talaga ito kasi once na nagkasakit, buhay kasi ang inilalaan natin dyan.
Manila's Trade Secretary insists local pharmaceutical firms have enough production capacity to supply paracetamol and other over-the-counter drugs to Filipinos. Social media users earlier raised concerns of a shortage in drugstores, prompting some to panic buy amid a new surge in COVID cases in the Philippines. But Secretary Ramon Lopez says there was no shortage of such medicines, but only stockouts in drugstores.
May malaki tayong production capacity ng mga local drug manufacturers. Very sufficient po. Hindi po ganun ang situation. Nag-stock out lang, out of stock, dun sa mga tindahan na yon. Ibig sabihin po nito, kailangan mag-reorder kaagad yung mga branches, yung mga drug stores na yon, mag-reorder kaagad sa mga manufacturers.
The Philippine government plans to start vaccinating children as young as 5 years old by early February. Health Undersecretary Mirna Cabotaje says they're just awaiting the delivery of Pfizer vaccines, which were formulated specifically for 5 to 11-year-olds. The Philippine Food and Drug Administration approved the jab for emergency use on children in December, saying it had a 90% efficacy rate with only very mild adverse effects. There are around 13.5 million children aged 5 to 11 in the country. President Duterte orders village officials to do everything they can to prevent the unvaccinated from leaving their homes. This includes restraining and arresting them if they insist on going out. Duterte also says he's prepared to face the legal implications of his order.
In the absence of a law, Presidente is called upon to act. And because it is a national emergency, I'm now giving orders to the barangay captain to look for those persons who are not vaccinated and just would request them or order them, if you may, to stay put. If he refuses, then the barangay captain, being a personal authority, is empowered now to arrest the recalcitrant persons. The barangay captain can also mobilize civilians and adopt them as a, well, give them the task officially, probably written, and that converts their status from being a civilian but also a person in authority called upon to assist the persons in authority. They can file cases. I'd be happy to answer. Sabi ko na, mayroon naman akong kaso sa ICC, di ipatong na ninyo para isang sagutan na lang pagdating ng panahon.